Tools. You and I use them a lot, but are we using them right or some not? Well, that is what we're kind of here to discuss, folks. So get ready to chop, smash, and crack your way through the Tools tab. Let's get to it. The plain old axe, or as Wendy puts it, an instrument for industry and murder. And you know what? She's absolutely right. When it comes to production, the normal axe fells big trees in 15 swings, medium trees in 10, and small trees in 5. But it has 100 uses overall, so it's not that bad. It's your early ticket to wood, and everything that comes with it. Duh. But have you considered becoming the axe murderer of the continent? It's not ideal, really. However, a super accessible craft that also deals 27 plus damage can potentially help many in the very early game, so keep it in mind. Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off the work I go. The pickaxe is very likely your second craft ever. So you best be sure to make the most out of it too. A normal pickaxe only has 33 uses, and it takes 6 picks to break open all types of boulders, so you really don't get too much out of it in the end. Again, be sure to mine wisely by first prioritizing flint-having boulders. Oh, and the normal axe also deals just above 27 damage, so perhaps you'll be breaking open some heads as well. Hammer time. No. Seriously, it's time to talk the hammer. And this puppy helps us demolish structures of most any sort. And most structures simply return half of their crafting materials needed to make them, like in the case of pig houses here. However, structures that have actual uses to them, like siesta lean-tos, tents, etc., return a varied amount of materials based on how many uses remain. So, keep that in mind, because you're not always going to be able to get the most efficient amount of materials back. Walls work differently as well, given that the materials needed to make them are usually already refined. So what you get from hammering them is actually the pre-refined material itself, i.e. rocks from stone walls instead of cut stone. And at the end of the day, we can hammer bones for bone shards, spoiled fish for bone shards again, pig heads for pig loot, bunny huts for bunny loot, we can bark mole worms for mongols, we can do the ancient pseudoscience machine for some terrifying spawns and loot, and just much more. It's a hammer. You smash things with it. But what if you desire to dig instead? Well, you'll be needing a science machine now in order to unlock some additional tools to fulfill that need, but I believe in ya. Get that shovel as soon as possible. A normal shovel only has 25 uses, so again, use it wisely. From the moment you have one, you should be refraining from simply picking resources like grass, twigs, and berries, and instead choosing to dig up their sources entirely for two birds, one stone sort of deal. A shovel is your ticket to self-sustaining resource plots and may just be the most important tool in the entire game. Oh, and resources aren't the only things that can be dug up as well. We got rabbit holes, mole worm mounds, mushroom spawns, etc. Shovels for the win. A shovel is very important, yes, but the pocket scale. The pocket scale is pretty darn awesome too, if you're into that sort of thing. But how important is the pocket scale, you ask? Well, it weighs fish and has 100 uses to do so. So, yeah. Pretty important. Jokes aside, there is a tool that may seem worthless, but is actually incredibly handy. The feather pencil. Feather pencils allow us to draw a nearby item on a structure called a mini sign. This is absolutely huge for base building and organization overall, and honestly is kind of essential for most of us out there. Furthermore, feather pencils are needed to create map scrolls off the cartographer's desk so that we can share our maps with our friends or newcomers to the world. absolutely marvelous. You know, I gotta be honest. I feel personally attacked by the description of the razor here. That being said, the heck can we use it for beyond blasphemous beard shaving? Well, in Don't Starve Together, its only use is really just shaving beefalo. Doing so provides 3 beefalo fur per beef, and the fur leads to insulating clothing for winter, saddles for beefalo riding, turf, fishing lures, and more. Key notes too, shave beef only when they are sleeping, and if they are in heat, you best have a beefalo hat atop your noggin when near them. But as much as I don't like it, we best briefly mention shaving beards. Both Wilson and Weber can use the razor to clean their faces, which results in various amounts of beard hair and or silk, respectively, depending, of course, on the length of the beards. But don't worry, we'll be talking more in depth about all things beards soon enough. Ah, yes, the pitchfork. A businessman's tool of the trade, I'd say. It does what it says it does. It moves the ground around. Turf and turfing is mostly purely decorative at the end of the day. However, there are some benefits to it. And I have a friend who happens to run a shop around these parts who just love the meetcha. So why not pay him a visit? As Wendy puts it once again, at least now we can kill trees with style. Gold tool time, and we best begin with the luxury axe. The axe has 400 uses total. 4 times that of a normal axe, mind you. But it still chops trees all the same in terms of efficiency. And that is something people always get wrong. It still fells big trees in 15, medium in 10, and small in 5. Just like the normal axe. So really, as you'll come to find out, all gold tools are just normal tools with increased durability. Like the opulent pickaxe, and I just noticed the description of said opulent pickaxe, and who the bloody heck still talks like that anymore. The opulent pickaxe is just like a normal pickaxe, but with 4 times as many uses. And yeah, I'm pretty sure you could have guessed that one. So pick away. But the last shiny tool, the regal shovel. And yes, you guessed it again, it's a normal shovel, but gold, and has 4 times the durability. So, get to digging like royalty. But honestly, it's probably only the axe and the pickaxe that you should be concerned about. Hey now, remember the saddles I briefly mentioned earlier? Well, it's their time to shine, and we might as well start at the bottom. A saddle allows the player to ride a beefalo during and after the domestication process, but only when a beefalo is tamed a bit and when their obedience is above 50%. Otherwise, the beef will just straight up reject the saddle and a ride. And by the by, a normal saddle provides a 40% movement speed increase. But as time goes on and the domestication process progresses, you might start looking into new butt spots, like the war saddle here. The war saddle only provides a 25% movement speed increase, however it allows a beefalo to deal an additional 16 points of damage to targets, so it's perfect if you're taming a beef to become an ordinary beefalo. And finally, the totally not unreasonable Glossomer saddle, and it's 68 butterfly wings needed to craft it. This saddle is all about speed, an extra 55% speed to be exact, so have fun zooming. However, let's start wrapping up here with even more dang beefalo related crafts, like the saddle horn. The saddle horn lets us remove these saddles without screwing up their durability, either by us forcing a new saddle on, or just the beef's shaking one off itself. But yep, that's about it. The brush is next, and is quite the expensive little bugger all things considered, with both steel wool from a Eucus and a tusk from a Mac tusk being needed. But the tool itself allows us to brush a beefalo once per day to receive a single piece of wool, as well as helping in the domestication process a bit. That being said, you can brush a beefalo more than once a day, but you don't get any of the benefits following the first one. And finally, the salt lick. The salt lick not only attracts both wild beefalo and koalaphants nearby, it keeps a beefalo's domestication percentage from dropping even if the player is doing nothing to help it. So having one while you are going about your other business is very, very important. Oh, and apparently, salt licks attract no-eyed deer and vault goats too. But really, these should be only used for beefalo domestication. But there you have it, everyone. The tools tab. Most things are pretty darn straightforward, but others perhaps not so much. So I do hope some of you out there have learned something new today. But thanks for watching, well wishes to all, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.